Looked like Passos had brought us to the right place. That was the chopper the Commando Sombra used to escape the nightclub attack. If Fabiana wasn't around here, then at least someone that knew where she was had to be. Here I was, some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. A bullet will sometimes work as well as a key. Idea what lay ahead, and as much as part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation right here. I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns. So far, I'd managed to keep a low profile, a bit out of character for a guy who's only comfortable with a bottle of whiskey or a gun in his hand. I guessed the center of the maze was in this direction. I kept moving toward the signs of life, rubbing them out as I went along. I'd seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Vai se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein!
Vá se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
Yeah.
I didn't want to think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. If only I could have taken something for the humidity. They probably made their ransom notes from the same glossy magazines they used to select their victims. This was a second request for payment. The best of intentions at the stadium weren't enough to cover it. The room I'd seen was somewhere up ahead. My blood was boiling. I didn't have time to wallow in guilt and misery. Just shoot and move. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all.
Thank you.
was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them.
A dor. Com a idade vem a dor. É dor de cabeça, dor de estômago, dor na virilha, dor nas juntas, dor de ressaca. É por isso que existe Interfectum. Interfectum é um analgésico forte para a dor forte.
This is INC.
We have reports of more violence erupting in Panama, where citizens are still reeling from this attack 2 months ago. Colombian paramilitary group United Souls of the People, or AUP, have been waging a campaign of violence and terror in the area around Bastidas, despite government attempts to stabilize the region. Staying in Latin America, an explosion of violence in Brazil's largest city, Sao Paulo, as much publicized initiatives to stop feuding between favela gangs and the police have completely failed. Some local activists blame much of the city's problems on the activities of right-wing groups Cracho Preto and Nova Garda, who they accuse of vigilante-style attacks in the areas of the city where police have lost control. Some human rights organizations report a slew of missing persons in the city, a topic that many observers say local law enforcement isn't taking seriously. This turmoil is shaping up to be a hot topic in next year's mayoral election. Right-wing candidate Victor Bronco was once a frontrunner, but is now falling behind in the polls. Well, there may be some political storm clouds out there, but the sun is shining in many regions today. Over to Marisol with the weather.
Here we go again. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise. They'd been making a reality show starring Sao Paulo's favorite housewife. Probably thought it would grease the wheels with the ransom money, but it only made me want to shove the cash down their throats. I could hear drilling through the wall. It sounded more like boat hull than bone, but I needed to be sure.
Porra! Cala a boca! Ninguém pode te ouvir, caralho! Sua burguesinha, safada! Vou te pegar, é? Vou te pegar antes que eu bote uma bala na tua cabeça.
There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play. But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did.
Não, velho, não. O irmão já falou, velho, ele quer inteira.
Aí, isso é jogar dinheiro no lixo, hein?
Caralho, cara, tá virando uma cilada essa porra, mano.
Thank you. It seemed Serrano's boys had targeted the entire Bronco family and didn't give a shit which one they pinched. Serrano had taken Fabiana through the garage door. I had to find a way to open it. Of this low-rent hell. Get through on the catwalk if I went back into the other room. These were the floor plans to the nightclub. Seemed Mr. Serrano liked to be prepared. Proper little Boy Scout. Thank you. hadn't seen Fabiana in a worrying amount of time, but at least I wasn't following the trail of her fingers. Malaria tablets might have been more useful out there. I had to keep on going across the docks. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. Maybe a few years before that as well.